Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is the 7th of May 2010, and I'm talking with Jan Nelson, CEO of Pan African Resources, listed on the AIM market mining sector, stock ticker PAF, share price 6.25 pence, market cap 88.02 million pounds sterling. Pan African Resources is also listed on the Johannesburg Stock Exchange. Web address panafricanresources.com. Jan, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
Hi, Harry. Thank you for having us.
The South African gold industry has a reputation for operating high-cost, deep underground mines with low grades and minimal growth potential. Does this describe Pan African Resources operations at Barberton?
No, Harry. I think we're a bit of an anomaly in the South African industry. Barberton mine is a shallow mine. It's a greenstone gold mine, so it's an extremely high-grade gold mine. We're one of the highest-grade gold mines in South Africa, grade well above 10 grams a ton. And we've got significant growth potential at Barberton, the life of Barberton exceeding 15 years. So we're really an anomaly, and I think that reflects in our result that we report on every half year, and it's quite marked from the other South African producers.
What guidance can you give investors about your results for 2009, Jan?
Harry, we did put out a release, so the guidance I can give is that our production will be above 97,000 ounces, so a very good improvement in production. As we've said, there will be a reduction in our cash cost, and there will be an increase in our total revenue. We will be paying a dividend, so all in all, I think shareholders can look forward to a very good set of results that will beat their expectations.
How secure and safe are your operations at Barberton?
Harry, we believe they are secure and safe. We did have a problem of criminal miners in December. We have taken the necessary actions and we've addressed that problem. And the result of that is that we've seen an increase in productivity on the mine, which has resulted in the forecasted increases in production. So as far as we're concerned, that issue has been put to bed now.
What is Pan African Resources' business strategy, Jan?
Harry, we have a very simple strategy. We're in the mining business. That's our core function, but we're in the mining business to make money. So we need to run a profitable company. And the criteria for running that is very simple. We run assets that have got low cash costs, high margins, and significant growth potential. And I think that's evident from our gold operations at Barberton, and it's evident from our recent platinum acquisitions. And I think that sets us apart from our peers.
What is compelling about the chrome tailings retreatment business with Phoenix PGMs and the RK1 PGM consortium, and what are the risks, Jan?
Well, Harry, believe it or not, there are no risks, and the reason for that is that it's operations that are run on surface. You run these operations of very few people, a low capital commitment, the payback on your capital is very short, and extremely high margins. Total cash costs on these operations are approximately $360 an ounce for PGEs, platinum group elements, whilst currently the basket price is sitting at $1,400 an ounce. So you can see substantial margins, low capital, few people working on the plant, which keeps the costs low, and a very healthy margin.
What is the lowest case base price for platinum?
Well, Harry, we believe from consensus forecasts that it's approximately $1,000 an ounce for PGEs. The current consensus view is about $1,400 an ounce. But in terms of our operations, you know, our total cash costs will be less than $360 an ounce. So even if the basket price falls to $600 an ounce, we still make extremely good money.
Has Pan African Resources walked away from the Manica gold project in Mozambique?
No, Harry, we are currently doing metallurgical test work to see if the project will be viable as a 30,000-ounce heap leach operation. The test work will be completed at the end of June, and when we have those results, we will be in a position to see whether the project can be moved forward as a heap leach operation that could produce 30,000 ounces, and so we'll have to wait till the end of June to see where we go with the project.
What is Pan African Resources' financial situation going forward, Jan?
Well, Harry, currently we have in excess of £12 million in the bank. Barberton is currently generating anywhere between £800,000 and £1 million per month. So we're in a very healthy position. We've got a lot of cash in the bank. We've got no debt. So a very, very healthy situation.
What is Pan African Resources' dividend policy? And do you plan to maintain your dividend?
Yes, Harry, we plan to maintain our dividend. Our policy is to continue to pay a dividend. I mean, we intend to run a profitable company. And despite the fact that we have capital commitments, we would like to pay our shareholders out some money every year. The amount of money will obviously depend on our capital requirements as we grow the business, but it's our intent to pay a dividend to our shareholders.
Has Pan African Resources listing on the main board in South Africa benefited the company in the way you hoped it would?
Yes, Harry, it certainly has. We started on the junior market, the Alt-X. We've recently moved to the main board. And I think in terms of our move to the main board, there has been certain South African funds that before couldn't invest in us that have now taken investment into us. There's more analyst coverage, and there's also more peer group review, which is quite good for us, you know, because we stand out as a much more profitable company than the rest of our peers. So we're getting a lot more funds looking at us, a lot more analyst coverage, and I think that's all positive for the company.
Do you think Pan-African Resources is valued fairly by the market?
Harry, I'm sure that any CEO will probably always tell you that they're not fairly valued. I'm going to tell you the same thing. I don't think we are, but I think the reason for that is that the value of our platinum business is not yet sitting in our market value. The reason for that is we've only recently put out the results around the platinum business, and currently there are two or three analyst reports that will come out that will give a value on that. And I think when that comes out, you should see a significant increase in our market value, and I think that's why we think we're not fairly valued at this stage.
What can investors expect from Pan-African Resources over the next 12 to 18 months, Jan?
Well, Harry, our results are out at the end of August, beginning of September, and as we've said before, I think our shareholders can expect results that will be better than they expected. Increase in production, a reduction in cash costs. There will be some very good news around growth, resource growth at Barberton. There's a big project we're working on, and I think there will be a significant increase in our resource base that can also contribute to our production moving forward. And then there will be more updates on our platinum business and where we intend to take that. So all in all, I think a lot of positive news that will come to the market.
How do investors need to think about the cost of mining gold in rand and dollar terms, Jan?
Well, Eddie, I think being a South African producer and our costs being in South African rands, the other factor that needs to be taken into consideration when looking at us is the rand-dollar exchange rate. Because there are times when the gold price in US dollar terms increases, but the rand strengthens, which effectively gives us a lower price for the gold we sell. So the effect of the rand also needs to be taken into account. However, we focus on keeping our costs down and keeping the margin up, and that's the way management needs to address that question. But I think for our shareholders, they need to also look at the effect of the rand dollar price.
Is Pan-African Resources still on the acquisitions trail, Jan?
Yes, Harry, we are, but we are looking for projects that are close to producing or are producing. So we are looking at investment in vehicles that generate cash, hence our recent option to acquire our stake in the ARCO1 consortium.
Finally, who will the finalists be at the World Cup in South Africa this summer, and who will walk away with the trophy?
Very simple, Harry. The final will be between South Africa and Australia, and without any question of a doubt, South Africa will beat Australia.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening. Please note, I hold shares in Pan-African Resources.